please, Taylor, come forth with the welcome, please.
Good evening, saints.
Good evening, angels.
Good evening, saints, friends, family, and guests. We are here today to celebrate Pastor Bowman and First Lady's 5th anniversary of Fellowship Baptist Church. And we also like to thank Pastor Bob Burgess for letting us use his sanctuary to have that celebration. I just want to thank everybody for showing up and helping us out. And have a blessed day.
We can have Deacon Lorraine Whiteside come forth and give us scripture.
Good evening, saints.
Good evening.
We're going to be reading the scripture out of Romans chapter 10, verse 14 and 15. Once everyone has it, say amen.
Amen.
Here's the reading of God's holy word. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how should they preach except they be sent as it is written? How beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Amen.
Amen.
We can have Pastor Robert Burgess come forth for prayer. And after that, we will have offering and gifts for honorees. If you'll make a check out, please make it out to Pastor Bowman for the honor, for the offering and the gift.
Before I pray, there was a few things that Pastor Bowman wanted us to share. And that is, we are two congregations in one building. One predominantly white, and our Methodist, one predominantly black, Baptist. However, it is in our brochure that we want people to come to worship what's going on in the church, not to be sitting in the seat.
Yeah.
And so it is our belief by offering two kinds of different worship that people have choice. That they can move back and forth. That has to have what we call coordinating care. When we got here, there wasn't much going on. Since coordinated committee got together, that is two churches combined. And we have started a Bible study with the war room. I've seen that movie, it's a marvelous movie. We have started a number of events at Bellingham, the car show, we have a hat show, and if all goes well this fall, we will have an urban garden here and an urban nutrition from Shalom Farms. We will also have a program for getting women out of the slave trade. I don't know if you know this, but Richmond is number 2 in the nation for slave trade. And we will also have English as a second language for East Africans. And we will hope to start a preschool. All in effort to make this church, both of our churches, relevant to the community. I know us Baptists and Methodists don't always get along. And I have to admit, when I first came here, I was like, I don't know. But I tell you, it has been an extraordinary blessing to have Pastor Bowman here with me as co-pastor of this area. And what a wonderful, loving spirit he has. We have some programs to get along with the program, but that's okay. We're moving forward. if you remember in the wilderness, what happened to the folks are right in line. And it's been a real joy. I've been in ministry full-time since 1998, and this by far has been the best place I've ever been. No other place. It's just great to be here. I tell you, I look forward to the meetings that we have. I look forward to worship on Sunday. On the 5th Sundays, we do a worship service together. And so it intermix our worship styles. And so it's a beautiful experience. And I'm glad you're all here to celebrate this wonderful anniversary. Flo has been an extraordinary help gate and a great person and loving and supporting her husband as well as my wife and I. Had some health issues last year. They were with us every step of the way. So, I can go on for a while. I'm going to let's pray.
Amen.
All right. Lord Jesus, we just thank you, Pastor Bowman and First Lady Flo. They have been a powerful witness in this congregation. We thank you for the love and care and concern for all the people that are here. Thank you, Lord, for their leadership and their direction that they've helped us towards a new vision, a new way to move forward, a new way that we can reach out into the community. And then that day comes and they ask, if Calvary disappeared, what would happen? How would the community get back? It would be impacted a great deal. And so we thank you for the cooperation between the two congregations that have been a real joy and a tremendous thing. We ask forgiveness, Lord, for when we have failed, but we have not been as much loving as we should be. We ask forgiveness for those whose hearts are still hardened and have not yet seen the new vision. We pray for those. We don't want to be angry or upset. We just want to love them and encourage them and support them on their way. And so, Jesus, I thank you. This place, this wonderful congregation we have, and I am truly humbled and blessed by the Lord. So, Lord, bless this evening, be the preacher this evening. Let the words just ring out from your Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And let us have a good time as we celebrate and come into the house of the Lord. Amen.
Gifts for our honorees. I'm gonna have someone give me a hand here. Harris, to please come forward for the introduction of our speaker.
or too shy or different things is keeping you from doing God's calling on your life. Mm-hmm. Praise God. But God has been calling me for a while. So it had to be in God's perfect timing to get me up here today.
Yeah.
Because I am one that would get so nervous about getting up in front of people.
Yeah.
See, I was behind the scenes kind of co-pastor. I would get up there and speak when I needed to, but I was kind of behind the scenes. My pastor was, anybody that know my pastor, know he was a lover of mankind.
Yeah.
He loved talking. He loved being a blessing.
Yeah.
He just loved being, he loved people. He used to try to tell me that this is what God is calling you to do. But other people can tell you what God wants you to do, but you got to know for yourself. God doesn't let you know perfectly what you need to do. So he would tell me this is what God wants you to do. God wants you to be a speaker. God wants you to get out. And I used to try to make excuses of God. And God used to, I used to have a discerning spirit, and God used to be pulling on me, and I knew what God wanted me to do, but it looked like I was running so fast, I didn't want God to catch up with me, because it looked like I was too nervous to get in front of people. Mm-hmm. Praise God. But God didn't give up on me. Praise God. So he kept after me, and he kept after me, and my pastor would tell me, praise God. And my pastor would say, one day, he said,
one day,
have to step up and pick up his dog. And I didn't pay too much attention because I felt like, he's going to be around. Uh-huh. But God was getting me ready. God knew that there was a time when I was going to have to step up and pick up that gauntlet and run the course. Praise God. So my pastor kept telling me, and I said, I'm perfect. I'm happy being in the background. I'm happy because you also need people in the back. Everybody can't be a chief. You need some Indians behind you to make sure you're ready. You need to do this is how you need to do it. And every now and again, my husband would tell me, that's like something you need to do. I think you need to do that. Praise God. People say, you got to pick up that gun. You got to be strong enough to pick it up. And I would say, one day, I will. But I still kept running because I just get so nervous. But I know God could bless me with anything I need to bless me. You see, I don't worry about my faith. It's not based on, praise God, trials and tribulations, because we all will have some trials and tribulations. Nobody said that life will always be easy. My faith is based on the presence of God. And so I listened to my pastor, and I listened to him, and I heard what he was saying. But one day, March, God said, all right, I'm going to call this man on home, and now is your time. This is your season. And I knew it was my time. Now, did I still try to do a little running? Yes, I did, every now and again, because I would get so nervous, I tried. But I knew God said, I don't want somebody else to do this position. I want you to do it. Mm-hmm. And then, when God started us in that church, he didn't give us a church that was full of members, but he gave us some members that were full of love. He wants me to do, praise God. Hallelujah, because, track. And there are times when I've talked to you one time, I've talked to you two times, I've talked to you three times. We had the same conversation over and over again. And sometimes we take it upon ourselves to say when enough is enough. But there's no way I can make that call. That's got to be God telling me that right now, I need you to, I don't care if you've done it 100 times, I need you to do it 100 times.
Yeah.
somebody over there in that audience. Go catch me. And he's telling me, I know if I do, somebody gonna catch me. I got to know that I got members that if I want. I take the members of my church. I fellowship with Pastor Bowman. Oh, Bishop Fisher, so many different ministers that I know that I can call on, and I know if I fall, they gonna help pick me up. God is making me ready. God said, now is your season. I'm making you ready. When you start to run, I want you to run all the way. I want you to stop along the way. I want you to keep on running for me. Normally, I would be so nervous up here, I probably would. I would be so nervous, y'all might have seen this thing shaking. But you know what? I'm just as calm
as hallelujah!
Always, let me tell you how I prepare for my messages. I'll sit up and I'll study and I'll type it up. Then I'll go back and I'll pull notes from it. Then I'll go back and I'll bold it and make it big. But then when God put me up to do it, I don't have time to look at it and see what's going on. I want somebody to come back over here and kind of get a quick peek and see what I got on there. But I won't have the time to do it because God get in the midst of my soul and God started. Put your next to read that paper. But I'm gonna give you the word I want you to have. I know what you say, but I will give you the word I want you to have.
Amen.
Praise God. So I thank God for that. I thank God. I thank God. I thank God. And I know we on a time schedule. But I tell you, when I get to talk about God, the goodness of God and all He's done for me, I can't lie to you. Some people feel like, oh, I got faith, but I don't even put forth any effort. But faith is an action word. You just can't sit down with God. I got to do something. You know, but believing, I got to believe, hallelujah, that God is all wrapped up and tied in my soul. And it's going to be all right. When I was going through my humble passing, God said, and then that's when I really wanted to give up. Oh, Lord, my backbone is gone. My earthly backbone is gone. But God said, I'm still in the midst. Because I knew I had an awesome name of God.
Yeah,
and it's getting better and better and better.
Yeah.
Praise God for His awesomeness. I give God the glory.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
So my message for today, I'm kind of amazed. Because I don't feel nervous. And normally my stomach be all in knots. Oh my goodness. My stomach will be in knots. But today, I just feel so high in my spirit. God is
pray hard enough, God will eventually turn that.
Yes, he will.
And I know he's strengthening me every day. With the help I got with the church members, with my family, he's turning things around for me. He's saying you can do it. My God said I can do it. I don't know if y'all believe I can do it. Well, my God told me I can do it. Because you just don't try to do it, but you can to do it.
Yeah.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
My God.
That's something I intend to stand on. I intend to stand on that word. Congratulations to Pastor Bowman, First Lady.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Congratulations. Awesome man of God. Always been in my corner. Was with Pastor, would have been with me since Pastor passed. They have been there. Anything I can do, if you need me, I'm there.
Amen.
And that's a blessing.
Amen.
It's a blessing to have good people. But if I walk around acting all snooty and like I'm all this and that, who do you think gonna want to find out with you? Nobody. If you want love, you got to show love.
That's right.
But I can sit down, man, and I'm gonna let y'all get a break. Because, hallelujah, I know y'all already getting ready to hear some good music.
Yeah,
no. And not only do the Kenny sing, I'm sure they're ready to sing. If it's something you're praying for, if it's something you're waiting on, if it's something you're standing in for, something you need in your life, just keep praying. Don't give up just because you haven't gotten it. Don't give up because it may have been a few months, but God is trying to get you ready so that he can bless you in what he got for you.
Amen.
You've got to wait on God and be of good courage, and I guarantee you he's going to show up.
Amen.
Pastor Bowman is one of the alumni of my Bible college. One thing about it, when he was in the college, he would always ask a question. I mean, every time I say so, his hand was going up. Told me one day, but a dumb person, the one never asked nothing. And I thank God for him, even asking us to come. Now, I got so much I want to say, but we're going to do what we got to do and get out of the way. I'm looking at the bulletin. The pastor said something. He said, you all have intermixed worship styles. See, I wrote that down. So when I was brought up Methodist, they're a little quiet sometimes. So in 1957, I went to Boston, Massachusetts. And I was walking down Columbus Avenue, I never forget, and I saw all this, heard all this noise, and looked in the door, little storefront church. They had shouted so much the floor was torn up, they were shouting on the ground. But I hadn't, you know, I just left North Carolina. The only time I hollered a lot was when I was behind the mule. So when I got up there, saw everything was going on, I started hollering, thinking about, see, it's two ways you think. You think about the goodness of the Lord, you get happy, then you think about the way I was thinking. I ain't behind that mule no more. And I started hollering. And I've been hollering ever since. So my group is going to come. If we get too loud, y'all just raise your hand and we'll kind of bring it down. We'll try. Now, the girls that's coming to sing with me, my wife and two of my spiritual daughters, they can sing. I can't sing. My wife always tells me, you ought to stop saying you can't sing. Let me, I'm going to prove something to her right now. Let me see everybody's hand. Raise your hand. See, baby, there's a whole lot of folks out there that can't sing too.
Son.
This young man on the drums, that's my son. He's 16 years old, Malachi. This is my spiritual daughter. She's been straight with me. How many years, man?
6 years.
Amen. This young man has been 3 years. Amen. Praise the Lord. What y'all waiting for? Oh, this one? That's my wife. I learned how to be a husband through her teaching. She is my pastor. Amen. I pastored her for many years. And that girl right there. That's, don't I look pretty good for 82? Oh, yeah. This is all for her. He said, black, don't crash. You should have never walked over here. I'm coming back. Whether you're black or not, I'm coming back. That man is one of, I tell you, he's one of our alumni out there, yeah, on Bible College. Yeah. I tell you, we had fun, didn't we?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yes.
He's a good guy.
Thank God. We thank God for meeting you. And one of the reasons I'm talking, let's get settled down so we can get down to business from there. Amen. Okay? All right, you ready, Dre? All right. My son do all my music. And we might sing something you don't know, but don't know it, just wave your hand and boom, and make you think you know it anyway. Amen. Let's go. That's right. Who that said that's right? 1965. My feet, my feet, too. Amen. 1965. 1965, I gave my life to Jesus Christ. Amen. 1967, I started preaching. About a month ago, let's say 3 months ago, I was sitting in the house pastoring some of my old girlfriends.
Keep on working on me. Thank you.
Jesus. For company. Hallelujah. If I didn't have Jesus, mom may leave you, daddy may leave you, even pastor may leave you. Are we doing all right? Don't fool me now. A lot of people talk about the cross. But Brother Vaughn, Deacon Vaughn, they don't believe it. We have the spirit of the road call. Here we go.
Oh, that's the bars! Hey! He used to say to my mama and I'm Catholic. Hey, y'all! Hey, y'all! Y'all remember the lady Snake called his son operator? And now carry it on the boom? Hey,
video, and that's what I had in there. I never get this day. Let me give you a little freedom. I miss you, baby. The scripture. Have you finished? Have you finished?
Yes, baby.
You know the song for who? Y'all wait till after service to talk. He even got a bit of Bowman on the window back. Y'all wait till he sang my song. I wasn't there when he spoke to the water. I wasn't there. Pretty calm, rain is sweet. I wasn't there when he preached on the mountain. I didn't see. I wasn't there. I wasn't there. When he died, I won't Calvary. I wasn't there. We rose from the dead. Yeah, he did rise. Huh? He's coming back too. I wasn't there when he ascended back to heaven.
Yeah.
same. The cross that he carried. They say your word, y'all.
Like our Savior did. And I didn't see the crowns of thorns they placed on Jesus' head. And I wasn't there when they marched him down. Yeah. heaven's way. Let's go, set our heaven's way. You want.
Lord. You gotta come back here, this official.
Come on, y'all, let's give this official God permission. Another round of applause. Man, you gotta come back here. That's the proofiest 82-year-old young man I ever seen. You know what? This has been my friend for a while, being this official. And you know what? I love this man here. You know, I love him, his wife. And like I said, you know, we've been friends a long time. You gotta come back, y'all.
Well, I will be asking. Pass the ball.
Hey, I enjoy this. And I think everybody out here enjoys this. Hey, work on me. You know, I like that. Work on me. I like that. That was, you know what, all those selections of songs really, really touched my heart this evening. But all the songs and all that good singing can't get you in heaven. Can't get you in heaven. You can be the greatest singer, the greatest songwriter in the world. But if your heart is not right with Jesus Christ, you can see him, but you won't be the way that you want to see him. So I'm going to ask you, if those who are able, if you could stand to your feet right now, as the doors of the church is open this afternoon, that's why I'll stand here with you right now. I want you to stand with me this afternoon. And I'm going to tell you what, this guy right here, since we've been here, we have gotten a bond together. This guy here, and I still, he's my brother in Christ. Until we get ready in our house, I understand that we are one God in Christ. Background you come from, we are all God's children. We have to get away from that colorlessness. We are all God's children. Pastor Bob has done for me, even when I was sick in the hospital, Pastor Bob was right there for me and my wife, and his wife, Bowman. I told him, don't be proud of me, because I know you can come in and do what I belong to. And he, poor fellow, looked at me, he was just crying. I said, don't you cry. But I'm glad that the Lord saw fit to keep him healing and hurt. And he was there for me. So I thank God. Thank God for the bond that we have here in this church, that we can come together and try to bring folk together, try to save lives, to say or tell somebody about Jesus Christ. And I thank God for that bond. So now, I ask you all to stand to your feet. Is there one today that don't know this Jesus Christ for themselves? Because you have to confess it with your mouth that God has raised Jesus Christ from the dead. You have to confess it. You know, and you're going to need him. You're going to need him one day. Everybody's going to need him. That means not and everybody. I don't care if you're a perfect singer. I don't care how much money you have given. You can't buy your way here. You can't. I don't care how much riches you have. But if your heart is not right, if you haven't loved and treated folk right, you know, you can go to church 366 days a year if you want to. You can. If you can get that, then. But I'm telling you this, if your heart is not right with God, there's no way. There's no way. You've wronged your fellow man. You've treated folk wrong. And it's there. I've seen it with my own eyes. Neglecting folk, treating folk bad. Folks need that help right now. Look at what's happening in the world today. Folks are getting flooded out, losing everything. Why we can't help right now? Why we can't help folk? But we are so stuck on ourselves right now. You got mine. I got mine. You get yours. We got to get away from that, folk. We got to. Let's help somebody along the way today. Let's treat people right. Let's love more. Let's stop treating folks bad, talking about one another like that. Let's do it. Let's see if we can do that. All right, is there one today that would love to give their life to Christ today? Just hold your hand up. Come on down. I said, I want to be with Christ today. I want to him to welcome me and say, hey, well done. I've done what you asked me to do, Lord. I've been your hands. I've been your eyes. I've been your feet. I've done what you asked me to do. I want to come out and work for you today. I want to start a new beginning in life. That's what I want to do. I want to change this bad lifestyle I've been living. I want to do something different in life. I don't want to be mean no more to folks. I want to change everything. That's what I want to do. What do you think about that? I'm going to light and start. It's a good start. Is there one today? Is there one? See, some years ago, I had a change. I tell my folks all the time, I was bad little joke. I was bad. Mean, nasty, doing it and everything. Going to club, hanging all night. Come back, grab some melon, that goat gut, doing it. Oh yeah, I was doing it. That's a testimony. But see, God had delivered me from a heart attack and pneumonia twice. Just like I was talking about. God had delivered me. God had delivered me. That's why I got to give him praise. I got to. And I thank him. That's who did it. God didn't do it. God did. That's why I'm thankful. See, that's why you have to put your trust in him daily. Every time before those feet hit the floor anymore, thank God. Thank God. Because without him, you can do nothing. You're not doing it on your own. Remember that. Don't get it twisted. Don't get it twisted. You're not doing it on your own, walking around with your chest puffed out. Because of him, that's why you're living. Because of him. I didn't come to preach with a sister who never already done that. But don't get it twisted. Because of him, that's why you're here. Amen? But if there one today, don't be ashamed of it. Don't be ashamed. Don't even care nobody looking at you. Because nobody there even got a hell of hell to put you in. Salvation is free. But it's you the one that's got to take that step to give your life to Jesus Christ. And we would love to have you here. Or you can go somewhere else if you want to, but make sure that you give your life to Jesus Christ. All of us are going to have to see him one day. All of us. There you go. And that's going to be a bad way. Is that one? All right, may God bless you. May have a smile upon you. Y'all can take a seat.
All right, where we at? Where we at? I know y'all ready. I'm ready to go. I don't enjoy so much good singing. Yes, Mr. Sir. Fish, I've been listening to y'all all night long. Yes,
sir. All right, let me see you. All right, wait a minute. I want some remarks. Come on, so we can hear them get on, get all back in the back. But tell me they got some good stuff back there. It'll keep me from the bag all this, all day long. Sister Odie?
Before we go first?
No, wait a minute. Before we do something, I got some friends. I got a whole lot of friends here. Family and everybody. But I'm going to thank everybody first. But my friend here, Sister Karen Bowman and her husband. Where at? There you go. Y'all stand for a minute. The Barbers, her husband and I was in the military back in the 70s, but my friends right here, y'all stand on my escorts. Me and him was in the military together in the 70s, all three of us. We had the military done. They are celebrating 29 years of marriage today. They came from Maryland to stay with me the weekend. They've been with me. And I tell you what, I love it. Right. And they were at escorts, they've been with us all the week. And I tell you, me and that guy, we got a lot of history together. Right. I had the church laughing, I told him this morning, my mama used to cook coon for him and everything and stuff. So we've been buddies ever since. He'll tell you, we've been boys. And also, my buddy back here, we was also in the same unit at Fort Eustis together. And I bought my first car from him. He had an old green car. But I painted that thing black and put some wheels on it. And I barely rolled up from Fort Eustis to Charles City in that thing. And I tell you what, I love him to death. All of us been friends, and we still friends. See, that's what you call staying close to his friendship. And him and his wife, I tell you, I love him. But I tell you what, she's a songbird. She can sing. But she wants to come, you sing a song. I got a little note here, sing a song. Is that what I got here?
Yeah. Put out and say, yeah, I want to come and sing a song. And she can sing too. But before I give my remark, will you come and sing a song? And she can sing too. They came up to my friend's retirement party. He just retired from AFES. He retired military. And he retired from AFES. And they came all the way up to Maryland. All of us was in Maryland together. As friends again. So that's how friends do. We stick together. And she sung up in Maryland too at Atlanta. She can sing. All right? Here she is. Miss Karen. Oh, let's give her a hand.
Praise God, everybody.
Praise God.
One of my favorite songs is He Looked Beyond My Faults and Saw My Need. God is so good. Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise.
Hospitality people, Bessie, my girl here, Miss Estelle. She did all of the arrangements. And she, I guess she had her helpers with her, but I don't know who was one, but she kept us out that social hall. Don't go in that social hall. That was a no-no. But we did our best, but he is very curious, and he was wondering, what are you doing? Need me help? Need me help? Oh, she said, stay away, Pastor. Stay away. So I just thank her for just having and arranging things the way she wanted it. And I just want to thank my husband for, you know, his pastoral time, and the Lord has blessed him, and just keep us in prayer that he will continue to bring God's word. Amen. Now these passages, Sister, where is she at? Sister Betty. Oh, well, Sister Betty and I, we made these passages. We were unexperienced, but we made it. We made it. I want to thank her for helping me with it, because I would do it by myself. So we did it. And other than that, I just kind of like this back in.
Thank you. May I ask all the pastors, the first ladies, the ministers, all y'all, please stand. I want to recognize my good friend, Pastor Taylor and his wife. They had to leave, so I want all of y'all to please stand. And Evangelist Guy came all the way from Maryland, and his wife told me, it's on a pleasure thing I just met. Please stand. They came all the way from Maryland. They came all the way from Maryland. But I do want to recognize all of you all. Thank you all for coming, all right? Then I want all the members from Fellowship to stand. I want to recognize some of them that already came. I want y'all always stand. All of the members from Fellowship, I want y'all to stand. Some of them already come. Thank God for all of you all and for all the work. This lady, like my wife said, she was hard on me. She, don't you come in here and all this stuff. She kept me away from here, boy. I couldn't say a word. But I thank God for all the hard work that she has done. And I hope when I get back there, probably my heart won't stop beating, man. But I mean, it's about to lit up back there, but I thank God for you. God bless you. And I know you've done everything out of the kindness of your heart. I just can't wait to get back there and see everything. Thank God. Amen. All right? And I just thank God for everything. And I got some family. I see my auntie back there, my cousins, and everybody up in here. Y'all stand up back there. I see my auntie. My cousins and everybody up in the house, I was really shocked. My honey, I'm back there, my cousin. Yeah. I'm so glad to see you all today. And God be the glory. A lot of my friends and all my folk in the house. Man, I'm overjoyed. Huh? Oh, my cousin. Oh, that was yes, here they are. And I thank God for all the programs, the people who I asked to be on the program. Bishop Fish and all that. Cheryl, I see y'all. You need to stand. You and my friends. And you and my husband. All y'all. Everybody, my friends. And thank God for your brother Bill. Amen. You and my friend. Thank God for you all. Thank God. Pastor Bob, we thank God for everything. No, I really do. All of you have come. Everybody. Now, don't y'all run and not go back there and get something to eat. Folks, get there running and don't go back and get nothing to eat. You know everybody like eat. You don't like eat, raise your hand. See, you know they ain't go up. Everybody like eat, because I sure like eat. Look at everybody looking at me. I like eat. Huh? Don't everybody like eat? Huh? I got good comment. Don't pass. So don't everybody run off. Let's go back there and fellowship and get something to eat before we go home. Alright? I know something good back there. I but to God be the glory. I thank everybody. Glad to see my friend Preston running for the 7-4 delegate back there. And I'm happy him campaigning. But I want to see some changes in Charles City, Newton, and Richmond. Because I know he's the man going to get the job done. I get tired of seeing him putting people in the seat not doing anything. But he's going to be a fighter. So that's why I'm happy him. So
There he is right there. So if you want to see him, you know this, we can talk to him. Alright? Right, Preston? Right, Friday today, man. You want to fly yesterday to County Fair down in Charles City.
Oh, yeah. I love me some Charles City.
We all
thought
you wondered, well, where's Calvin and I Griffin?
Yeah.
They're in the kitchen.
They're in the kitchen. That's right. That's right.
More of